In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to generate elevation data from Google Earth Pro and then use the same data to generate or create contours in AutoCAD Civil 3D. So I'm going to open up Google Earth Pro, and in this search tab we are going to type in the area of interest. So Tigoni is my area of interest. I'm going to click search, and it's going to zoom into the location where I want to generate my contours. So what we're going to do, I'm going to create path. So you create on path and give it a name, say just say contour data, or just call it elevation data. Let me just call it elevation data, like so. And the line color, I'm going to give it red, so everything looks good. Measurements is meters, and then I'm going to generate contours for this area here. So what you need to do, just press down left click, and then do not leave or do not release your mouse, and then just move your mouse around. Remember, I've just pressed down left mouse, and I'm going to move your mouse around and only release when you are done. So I'm going to do this. You can so I want data for all for this particular area here, and we want to densify the contours as much as possible, and therefore you need enough data for this exercise. So you just move around. It's like you are digitizing, but now automatically you're just moving your mouse while holding down your left mouse. I think that is enough for our exercise. I'm going to release my mouse and then click OK, and you can see that our data has been saved on places in this application. So I'm going to right click and save it in where I want. So let me just create a folder here. I'm going to call it contours, like that. So I'm going to save this KML in that particular folder, and to do that I'm going to right click on elevation data that we've just created and click on save place as, and I'm going to change the file type to KML and then click save. Now that we are done with the Google Earth Pro, I can go ahead and close that. Now open up a browser, any browser that you have. For this case I'm using Chrome, and type in GPS visualizer and you hit enter. Click on the first link, www.gpsvisualizer.com, and then click on at the top here. You can either click here convert file, or you can just click on this one, on this link, convert to plain text. Let me just click on this, and then make sure that plain text is selected, the radio button for plain text, And on file one, you're going to choose a file, elevation data, and open. You can see now it has been uploaded. And before you hit convert, first of all, you need to do some settings. At the bottom here, add DEM elevation data. You can see it saying no. Just click on it and select best available source. But you can also select any of these depending on your data. For this case, I'm going to choose best available source. And then I'm going to expand on this, show advanced options, and go to the bottom where we have miscellaneous options. And make sure that output UTM coordinates is selected as yes. So just click on yes. Now we are ready for converting our data. You click on convert. The moment you click on convert, first of all, you can see you have been provided with download link, and you can see the preview of your data, and we can see that we have elevation column here. So you click on this download link, and you're going to see that our data will be downloaded. Now I can go ahead and close down the browser and open up, go to downloads where we have our data. It's right here. I can as well convert or rename that to elevation data, like that. And I'm going to cut it so that I can paste it in our folder here in our working space. So paste it right there. Now that we have this one in TXT, and you can see I have already installed Excel. What I'm going to do, I'm going to open this data in Excel and then convert to CSV data. So right click on it and click on open with Excel. Then I'm going to get rid of the columns that I don't need. So I don't need these ones here. Click on delete cells. And then I'm going to reorganize my data. So I'm going to add two columns right there. And I'm going to select the nothing column so that it comes before the easting. And then just right click and then cut and paste it just before eastings. And then I'm going to get rid of that. So in AutoCAD, my data is going to be in a form point nothing, easting, elevation, and then description. So here, let me just expand that and then center so that we can have a look at our data. Now, let's say this point number, and I'm going to type 1, 2. We want our data in sequence, and the moment I've typed 1 and 2, I'm going to select all of the two cells and double click on E. And then our last cell, we said, is going to be a description, like that. So I'm just going to give it random, 0.1, PT2, select all of them, then double click. So I'm going to get rid of this column or row, click on that, and then we're going to save the as data, save as, browse to our working space, and file type, I'm going to select comma delimited, CSV comma delimited, and then click on save. Now our data is in CSV. I can now close that down. And then we are going to open up AutoCAD Civil 3D. And the first thing that you need to do is unit setting. You type in unit setting, units command, and we're going to the length or distance precision. I'm going to select two decimal places. Angle is going to be clockwise. Direction, I'm going to choose north. Click OK and click OK. Now I can now click on save and save it in our working space as well. So I'm going to call this contours. You can call it any name that you want. So click on save. And then we are now going to import the CSV data. Click on points, go to import stroke export, then select import points. Now our point format, first of all we need to specify file format, and we can remember I told you that my point is going to be in point, nothing, easting, elevation and description. You click on that to highlight and click on add file button. I navigate to the location where you have your data, click on elevation data and click on open. Now you can see we have the preview of our data, so you just click OK. And to view our data, just click or just type ZE command, that is for zoom extend. You click enter. Now we have our data here. We can as well label each and every point. So you say just select one, right click, and then select similar. Now go to properties, click on properties here, or you can as well right click inside here and choose properties, and then under point labels select description only. For this case I'm going to select description only, but there are several options that you can choose. And then click Control Save, Control S to save, and I'm going to change the font. So go to annotate, under annotate click on this window launcher. And here under font name, I'm going to type a T so that we can have Times New Roman. I'm going to click apply and OK. Now we have our points ready. It's time now to create contours. So the next step is to click on tool space and then make sure that you are in Prospector tab right here. And then the first thing when you are creating contours, you first create surface, that is in AutoCAD Civil 3D. So right click on surfaces and click on create. So we're going to give our surface a name, call it contours. And then style, I'm going to click on style and click on this button. Then click on this pencil. I want now to set my contour intervals. I go to contours tab and click on expand on contour level intervals like that. So I want my minor intervals to be 2, and this one I think 10, or let me make it 5 is okay. Oh no, let me just okay, let me make it 6. Then I'm going to click apply. Okay, render material, this is just optional, you can leave it as default. So I'm going to click OK, and then if you can now see surface on these surfaces, there is a plus. So under our contour surface, expand on it, and then expand on definition. So under definition, you need to look at point group. Now you right click on point group and click on add, and make sure that you select all points, because those are the points that we have just imported here. Now you click on OK. Now automatically you can see now contours have been created. The next step, you want us to smoothen our contours. For that, now click on still under definition, right click on edit, go to smooth, and then on select output region, click on here, and then this button will appear, click on it. So under command, at the command line, just select surface, or you can just type S and click enter. The grid spacing, the grid X spacing, double click there, and let me try one, the same for Y, then click enter. You can see our points are going to be around 1.3 million. I think that's okay, that's fine. I'm going to click enter, and the points is going to take a while, because those points are actually too many. Now that we have smooth contours, as you can see, the next step is to label our contours. But I can decide to select all these points and hide. So I can hide all the points, and then now we want to label our contours, so we can as well hide that. So in order to label the contours, just go to annotate tab and then add labels. Under surface, I'm going to label multiple contours like that. Then you can just label the contours like that. Like that. So if I zoom in, you can see now we have our points, and our contours have been labeled successfully. So that's how you generate elevation data from Google Earth, and then you create the contours on Google Earth Pro. That's all for this tutorial, and see you in the next one.